Hello guys, welcome back to another video. So I'm trying something new. This is the first episode of my weekly Unreal Engine devlog, where I'll be showing off whatever project or system that I've been working on. No fancy edits, no over-the-top scripting, just me sharing my progress, the struggles, and hopefully some cool stuff along the way. So this week we're talking about my dinosaur riding system, something I've originally wanted to add to my multiplayer survival game course, but I had to cut because, well, it got way too involved. I grabbed a bunch of dinosaur models from Sketchfab, hacked together a mount system similar to Ark Survival Evolved, and let's just say some of the animations are pretty rough, but yeah, it's definitely still a work in progress. But hey, the whole point of this series is to show the real messy side of game development. No polished AAA stuff here, just me trying to make some cool things and sometimes failing spectacularly. So if you're into Unreal Engine, game dev struggles, or just want to see some dinosaurs, stick around and let's get right into it. So originally these were designed for my Unreal Engine 5 multiplayer survival game course, and if you haven't checked out the course, I recommend you do. Basically, I have a full 70-hour course that will show you how to make the complete multiplayer survival game that has sort of similar mechanics inspired by survival games like Ark or Rust. We're talking about things like, you know, drag and drop inventory system, crafting mechanics, you know, base building, all that stuff. It even has stuff like a open world map, so I'll show you how to make that, you know, tribes and clan system, proximity voice chat, saving and loading, and even dedicated server hosting. So this course is just absolutely jam-packed, and I'm actually in the process of remastering it and upgrading it to a newer version of the engine. It's like at lecture 190, but you can pick them both up right now for the price of one on my website. So you can check out the full original course with 70 hours, 250 lectures, in addition to the remastered course, which you can get free bundled together. So check it out, link in the description below. But anyways, these assets over here were going to be for the remastered course because I was, you know, redoing the whole thing. And so I really wanted to add some sort of dinosaur taming, mounting, and breeding system in addition to these items. So let's actually show off what we have here. Basically, this is like a, you know, pterodactyl or PT with a saddle. All of the dinosaurs actually comes with saddles. So I actually got all these models from Sketchfab. All the models that you see here are actually from Sketchfab. So if you wanted to, you could actually download these for free, find them on Sketchfab. But basically these are the ones that were rigged, some of them animated. So I think this one actually didn't come with animations, but I'll show you the animations that I created myself. But you can see this is what the saddle actually looks like. They're not super fancy. This is like a horse saddle. Basically I went into Blender and remodeled them, but you can see the different egg variants too. I got this egg model and changed the color parameters. So this is like the Anki. So the Anki has another different saddle on him. And this is sort of like the baby dinosaur variant. So this is what it'd look like if you were to, you know, breed the dinosaurs and raise them from the eggs. So I really wanted to add like a taming system where you could tame them wild and then you could breed them and raise them from the eggs. So here we have a trike. See what the trike saddle looks like and the trike baby. But yeah, the saddle is absolutely massive. Again, this is just like a horse saddle. I think you can actually just download this from Sketchfab as well. Okay, this is the Stego. So I kind of love the Stego model. It's super detailed. And you can see what the saddle looks like. Okay, the player will sit right up there. So very similar to Ark, pretty much. Even the Rex saddle itself, which is one of my favorites. Okay, you can see what it looks like. And I think all the dinosaurs were animated. So I think the Rex, the Stego, the Anki, other than the Trike and the PT, were all animated and rigged. So pretty much it's just like setting up the animations, the blend space, all that stuff. But yeah, that's the Rex egg. It's much larger and you can see the character model for scale. But I wanted to add like a dinosaur riding taming system, and it could be owned, you know, by the tribe. So, you know, any tribe members can ride the same dinos, and also it'd have the same abilities. So you can have, you know, your bite, your tail swings or whatever. Also, like the Anki could harvest, you know, resources with its tail. And in addition to that, I wanted to add these other items. This is like a generator because I was going to add things like turrets. So you could have like a turret that would shoot. You can even have like dinosaur soaking. So like if you played any of PvP servers on Ark, you could soak, you know, people's turrets or their base with, you know, various different dinosaurs. And of course you have the air conditioning unit. This is what you use to, you know, cook down the dino eggs. And then we have things like a torch. I wanted to add stuff like C4, but I just didn't get the animations for this in time. Also different items like a shotgun, sniper rifle, and pistol. We do have currently a rocket launcher and a rifle, but you know, just more different variants for those items. And I even created all the icons. This is in my survival game project here. But if I go to my DLC, over here are all the items that I made. So I created all these icons, but unfortunately, again, I just ran out of time. So the AC unit, Hanky Egg, Saddle, C4, Gasoline. So this is just some more work that I've done. But over here, I have a separate project in which I was working on all of the animations. And I was experimenting with the dinosaur riding. So if I hit play, this is basically like what I was working on. So you see the PT has a simple, you know, idle animation, which I animated using Control Rig. So it's actually super, not the greatest animation. You can see I have a walk, but when I press spacebar, it'll go into flying mode so I can actually fly in the air. And then I can press shift and it'll fly faster. Again, the animations aren't super good. They're just pretty janky because it's like the first animation that I've ever created for a creature. So yeah, this is like the walk, the idle. But it's very similar in Ark where, you know, you can land anywhere, take off and fly. And yeah, those are the dinosaur. These animations actually got from Sketchfab. So like the T-Rex idle, the Stego idle, even I don't think the trike is animated. So I think there's an animated trike on Sketchfab, but it's, I have to like figure out how to retarget it for that one. Also the Anki, you can see this guy has an idle. But I think I also set up this Stego as a character, so let me go ahead and see if I can spawn in as that guy. Okay, so here's the Stego. Yeah, I don't have the character on the top, but you can see basically what it looks like when the Stego is walking. I set up some basic logic for the character to walk around. Kind of need to nerf the speed because they're not this fast. But yeah, that's kind of like what it looks like. I had some procedural lean set up so that when you turn left or right, the Stego will rotate the body. Well, it's just super basic what I set up in the project, the animations, all that stuff. Again, this is something that I wanted to add to the survival game course, but I just ran out of time because there's just so many animations that you need to add, like tail swing animations, bite, like knockout. So I just didn't have the time to create all this stuff in addition to creating all the blueprint logic. So I'd have to create, you know, the actual character class and ownership, not to mention stuff like the containers. So they'd all have to have their own separate inventory containers because you can store items in the dinosaur, plus things like stats, breeding, all that stuff. So it's just a whole bunch of stuff that I just never got around to doing. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video and for, you know, this weekly devlog episode. Just kind of showing off some of the work that I've done in the past, maybe some of my previous work. But yeah, let me know what you guys think about this down in the comments down below. Anyways, let me know your guys' thoughts in the comments, and that's pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one.